Hello everyone, Dr. Natasha this side. Welcome to our channel Pharmacy International. Today's topic is about the course to become pharmacist in three different countries, and the name of the countries is Canada, the USA and Australia. So in this video you will come to know about the approximately course to become pharmacist by clearing the exams, plus you can compare the course of three different countries. And if you want to know the procedure, the step-by-step procedure to become pharmacist in those countries, you can just click on the link that is given in the description, and from that link you will come to know the complete detailed procedure to become pharmacist in Canada, USA and Australia. So without wasting any time, let's get started about the course to become pharmacist in the countries. Number one is Canada. For Canada, the examining board is PEBC, that is Pharmacy Examining Board of Canada. And the course for the number one step, that is Pharmacy Gateway Canada, you have to enroll yourself in the Pharmacy Gateway Canada. And the course for that is $340. And the next step is document evaluation. You have to evaluate your degree from that particular examining board, and the cost for the same is $675. After completion of your document evaluation, now you can sit in EE, that is evaluating examination, and the cost for the same is $870. Once you are clearing your EE, then you are going to appear in your qualifying examination, and the part 1, that is MCQ, cost for MCQ is $815. And then there is OSCE examination, that is OSCE, and the cost for the same is $1835, that is $1835. And those dollars are according to their particular currency. So you can say these dollars are in CAD. Approximately cost to become pharmacist in the USA. The first step is FPGEC, that is Foreign Pharmacy Graduate Examination Committee certification. And if you are an international graduate, then you have to go for that certification. And that certification includes number one, application fee. And the cost is $100. Next is evaluation fee, means you have to evaluate your degree from that particular board of the examining board of pharmacy. Then the cost for the same is $450. Once you are done with your application as well as your evaluation fees, now you can sit an FPGEE, that is Foreign Pharmacy Graduate Evaluating Examination, and the cost for the same is $650. And in case if you haven't cleared the EE, that is FPGEE, in your first attempt or in any of the attempts, you can retake the FPGEE with the same application, but the cost will be $750. So average, you can say for the first attempt the cost is $650. Once you are done with your FPGEE, then the next step is NAPLEX examination. But yes, before NAPLEX examination there is one pharmacy internship, that is approximately of 1500 hours. But yes, after that you have to clear the next exam, and the next exam is NAPLEX, that is North American Pharmacist Licensure Examination. Cost for the same is $475, and the last examination is MPJE, that is Multi-State Pharmacy Jurisprudence Examination, and the cost is $150. So this is all about the cost to become pharmacist in the USA. And in this course there are some requirements. For example, IELTS or TOEFL. Basically in USA the TOEFL is the one which is acceptable, but the cost of TOEFL is not included in this particular video. Let's talk about the course to become pharmacist in Australia. Number one, there is requirement of skill assessment eligibility letter, and for getting that letter you have to send your documents and every other thing to the PEBA, that is Pharmacy Board of Australia, and the cost for the same is $1290. Next is CAPS. Once you are getting your skill assessment letter in your hand, then you can apply for CAPS examination, that is Knowledge Assessment of Pharmaceutical Sciences, and the cost for the same is $2140. once you are done with your CAPS examination, now you are going to do the internship, and while you are doing your internship, you can go for the intern written examination, and the cost for the same is $710. After written examination, there is one oral examination, and the cost for the same is $335. So this is a rough idea to become a pharmacist in Australia by clearing those 2-3 examinations plus getting the skill eligibility letter. In this particular course, there are some other courses. For example, if you want to reappear in any of the examination, then there are some of the courses. Plus, you have to appear in English language requirement test as well. So, in this video, these all tests course is not included. It's just rough estimated idea to become pharmacist in particular country by clearing those examinations. If you want to know the procedure to become pharmacist in Australia, what you can do, you can click the link given in the description, and from that link you will come to know the detailed procedure to become pharmacist in Australia. This video has not included the cost of number 1 IELTS or TOEFL examination, which is required in any of the countries if you are going to go for the examination. Second, this video has not included the cost to register yourself in that particular area. Obviously, if you are going to clear your examinations, and after clearing all of the examinations, you must have to register yourself, and there must be some of the costs to become or to register yourself in that particular area. So this video has not included that cost as well. So it's just a rough estimated idea or rough estimated cost to become pharmacist in different countries. What you can do, you can convert that particular currency. For example, the cost is 815 CAD. So you can convert this particular CAD into your particular country's currency. So you will get to know a rough estimated idea about the procedure as well as cost to become pharmacist in those countries. So that's all about the procedure and cost to become pharmacist in the countries. Thank you. Have a great day and good luck to you. If you want to know about the procedures, means how to go for document evaluations, how to send documents to the respective board of pharmacy boards, right? So you can contact me on Instagram as well as on Facebook. I have the page on Instagram as well as on Facebook with same name, that is Pharmacy International. You can contact me over there, or you can comment in the comment section box. Any suggestions are most welcome. If you want any of the videos to be get uploaded, you can just suggest me and I will try to make it as soon as possible. Thank you. Have a great day and all the very best.